Okay, Shiv Sena workers have reportedly attacked the former BJP ideologue Sudheendra Kulkarni. In fact, reports coming in are saying that Shiv Senics did throw paint on him. Kulkarni, in fact, is the chairperson of the body, the Organizer Research Foundation. This is the CCTV footage that we're getting right now of that attack that was made against Sudheendra Kulkarni earlier on by the Shiv Sena activists when these people came out, pulled him outside of the car and smeared him with black paint. In fact, he is a key organizer of the former Pakistan Foreign Minister, Mr. Khurshid Mahmood Kasuri's book launch that is going to be taking place later on in the evening at the Hall of Culture Nehru Center in Mumbai. We're trying to take a look at these visuals. There you can see it, the attack by these party workers who smeared Mr. Kulkarni with black paint. So his car was stopped. He was asked to come out. In fact, when my colleague Mustafa did get a chance to speak to Mr. Kulkarni earlier on, he did mention how, you know, his car was first stopped, then they threw paint on the window of his car door, and then he was asked to come out, and then they poured the black paint over him. Exclusive CCTV footage that we're showing you right now on our channel, where we can see how Mr. Sudheendra Kulkarni, who is the chairperson of the Observer and Research Foundation, was smeared with black paint before being let off. And that's the car in which Mr. Kulkarni was traveling in, and it stopped because it was stopped, and there we can see two to three people walking towards his car door, asking him to get out. And according to Mr. Kulkarni, first paint was thrown on the window and then he was asked to come out. We have with us our Mumbai Bureau Chief Sahil Joshi for more on this. Sahil, I'm just taking the audience through the visuals that we are seeing on our screens that has been accessed by the CCTV footage that we can see, and we can just see how, you know, Mr. Kulkarni was attacked and was smeared with black paint by the Shiv Sena activists.
Absolutely. In fact, it looks like that it was already planned by Shiv Sena. It did not happen at the spur of the moment, because they were waiting for Sudheendra Kulkarni to get out of his house, to get in the car. While he was going to the outer gate of his society, he was stopped in between. Sudheendra Kulkarni stopped his car. He got down to speak to them, and immediately his face was blackened. So it was a planned attack by Shiv Senics. And now Sanjay Raut, Shiv Sena spokesperson and member of Rajya Sabha, has clearly accepted that it was Shiv Sena who did attack Sudheendra Kulkarni, blackened his face. As we just saw a while back, the Sudheendra Kulkarni categorically told media that he is going to go ahead with the book launch function and he's not going to be cowed down. Now, we have also got reaction from Devendra Fadnavis, in which he has clearly said that yes, the government is going to provide the venue with the security, and at any cost they will not allow this function to be stopped by the Shiv Senics. But it looks like that now the Shiv Sena has taken this whole issue as its own ego, and because of that, it looks like that the whole day we will be seeing various protests around Mumbai by Shiv Senics.
But you know, Sahil, the Shiv Sena remains absolutely unrepentant and unregretful about the incident. In fact, when I was listening to Sanjay Raut, he called it this is Seedhi Sadha, in fact, tarika tha for this attack. He's called it a mild attack and saying that they will continue to launch such attacks in the state, which is a direct threat to the state government with whom they are in alliance.
Absolutely. In fact, by doing this, Shiv Sena has completely challenged the Chief Minister of Maharashtra. Shiv Sena and BJP's relations are not going that well. We have seen that yesterday when Narendra Modi, Prime Minister, was here in Mumbai. He was addressing a public function at MMRDA ground. He was revealing, he was laying foundation of Baba Saheb Ambedkar Memorial in Mumbai, also Metro 3 project. None of the Shiv Sena leader was present on the stage, and it looked like that the BJP has hijacked the whole event. And today, by defying Chief Minister, who clearly said that yes, the government is bound to give the security, and by the duty, they are bound to give the security for the function, even if they do not agree with most of the thoughts shared, which will be shared at that particular function. But despite that, it's government's duty to provide the security. And despite that, the alliance partner in the government has clearly gone against the Chief Minister's orders and have reacted the way they want to react. And now Sanjay Raut's reaction, it's not for the first time that Shiv Sena has reacted in this way. Shiv Sena have always had such kind of past in which Shiv Sena has gone down to the methods of Gundaism.
Yes.
They have come down on the streets. We remember that to oppose the India-Pakistan match at Wankhede Stadium, Shiv Senics have even gone on the stadium and had dug in the pitch, and after that we have seen no further India-Pakistan matches in Mumbai. Now about Kasturi's function, he's a former diplomat, he's former minister of Pakistan. His book was launched in Delhi first. Lal Krishna Advani, BJP stalwart leader, had attended that function, and despite that they are going against the chief minister's assurance to provide security to the function and have gone down to the method.
Mr. Sudheendra Kulkarni, they're not really backing down from his stand, going ahead with the book launch. Remember, Mr. Khurshid Mahmood Kasturi is in India for the launch of his book, Neither a Hawk Nor a Dove, an insider's account of Pakistan's foreign policy. It's going to be a grand event that is going to take place later on in the evening at the Hall of Culture, Nehru Center. Let's get in a quick word. Sahil, just stay with me. I just want to get in a quick word from Amrita Shehgal, who joins us for more on this. Amrita, just take us through the security preparedness that has been put in place in the wake of this attack that has been made against Mr. Sudheendra Kulkarni.
Sudheendra Kulkarni just took a press conference and he clearly said that we know that Shiv Sena is opposing this entire program, but we will not stop this program. The book launch will take place in the evening. That is what he said. Also, there was Mr. Kasturi present in the press conference. He also said that I have come here for the for giving the peace message, and we want this book launch to happen. You asked me about the security behind me. You can see there's huge security deployment by the police. They are checking each and every vehicle which is going inside. They're asking for identity cards. Definitely, we all know that Shiv Sena has clearly said that we will not allow this program to happen. Shiv Sena clearly said that we will be coming on the roads and protesting against this program. And because of that, it is a big task for Mumbai police to carry out this program, to give protection to this program. And also a big task for BJP, because Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis said that I've asked the police to give the security to this program. But if the biggest ally member Shiv Sena has clearly said that we will not allow this program to happen, that this itself is a big task for government, for BJP, and also for Mumbai police to maintain the peace and security. Because we all know that yesterday also there was one car burnt. We have seen outside the Nehru Center, though police is not accepting that this was done by Shiv Sena. They are saying that this was the case of the car was old and it happened because of some other reason. Okay. That is what the police is maintaining now. But somewhere the clashes between Shiv Sena and BJP are increasing now, and big task for Mumbai police to maintain.
Absolutely. Sahil, I want to talk about the Shiv Sena. As you rightly mentioned, in the past we've seen how the Shiv Sena has flexed its muscles and have resorted to strong arm tactics, but now they're in an alliance with the state government. The party itself does enjoy unbridled political power, but I just wonder why the state government is not being forceful to end the Shiv Sena's sudden veto power on every issue in Mumbai or Maharashtra.
See, now this is really surprising. The Shiv Sena leaders are openly threatening Sudheendra Kulkarni and organizers of Khurshid Kasturi's book launch function that they will be facing dire consequences if they go ahead with the function. Sudheendra Kulkarni met with Shiv Sena chief Uddhav Thackeray yesterday night. He spoke to India Today and clearly said that he tried to explain to Uddhav Thackeray why he is having that book launch in Mumbai. Uddhav Thackeray in the morning clearly cleared the position of Shiv Sena by saying that yes, Shiv Sena will go ahead with the opposition to this particular book launch function. We saw what happened to Sudheendra Kulkarni in the morning. We spoke to Devendra Fadnavis, the chief minister. He said that they are duty bound to give the full-fledged security to any foreign national who has arrived in Mumbai with a proper visa. But despite that, police is not taking action against any of the Shiv Sena leaders, despite they know that who is doing this.
Why do you think, Sahil, from all your experience, because they enjoy a power that is not even drawn from any electoral mandate. So what is giving them this renewed power and strength to take a call on so many issues in the state of Maharashtra?
Avantika, this is like history repeats itself. Even during Shiv Sena BJP's government, earlier government, that was from 1995 to 1999, despite being in the power, Shiv Sena even then had gone down to this violent methods, and because it was their government, no action was taken against them. Even now we can see that Ghulam Ali's function was cancelled because it was an open threat by the Shiv Sena. Despite that, the government did not do anything. The government's the chief minister and the Home Department clearly said that because no one came to them with a complaint, now they cannot do anything about that. Similarly, now today we are seeing that this time Sudheendra Kulkarni clearly went to the government, to the Home Department, to the police and said, yes, we need the security because we have been threatened by like that. Despite that, the government is not acting. Yes, the security has been provided to the venue. Security has been provided where the press conference happened at this point of time. But there needs to be an assurance. Now, we also tried to speak to chairman of Nehru Center, where this function is going to happen. The book launch function is going to happen. Now, surprisingly, the chairman of the Nehru Center is none other other than NCP chief Sharad Pawar. We spoke to him. Sharad Pawar said that as a Nehru Center, as a venue provider, we have provided a venue for the book launch, as we provide for other functions. We have been promised by the government that appropriate security arrangements will be made at the Nehru Center. We haven't asked the organizers to cancel the function. Now it's government's and organizers' duty to have that particular function peacefully. More than that, he has nothing to comment about. So basically now this time it completely comes down on the government to ensure that this function happens without any issues from Shiv Sena.
And that could be a matter of great pride for the government as well, Sahil, isn't it? With the ball now coming into the government's court.
Absolutely, Avantika, and more so that where the similar function happened in Delhi, the stalwart of BJP, Lal Krishna Advani, was one of the attendees of that particular function. He was there on the stage with Khurshid Kasturi. He was there on the stage with Sudheendra Kulkarni. And the same government, same BJP government, will have to ensure that the function at 5:30 should happen without any problem from the Shiv Sena. And they clearly know that what are Shiv Sena tactics. It's not that they do not know Shiv Sena well. They have been with alliance with Shiv Sena since last 25 years. They have seen Shiv Sena. They have seen their methods. They know how to tackle Shiv Sena very well. This time, for the first time, that the Home Department is also with the BJP and the Chief Minister is also of BJP. So they will have to ensure that this particular function happens. It's going to be a litmus test for the BJP government and the Chief Minister how this particular function goes smoothly.
All right, Sahil, thank you so much for speaking to us and giving us more insight and perspective to, you know, the kind of events that have unfolded in Mumbai just in the run-up of that launch of Mr. Khurshid Mehboob Kasuri's book that was to take place in Mumbai later on in the evening. In fact, that launch will go on as per schedule. Let's just listen into what Mr. Kasuri had to say about the attack that was made against Mr. Sudheendra Kulkarni by Shiv Sena activists.
As a political worker, I recognize the right of people to protest. But I've always understood that as long as it is peaceful, it's justified. It is inherent in the constitution of Pakistan, India, and of other great democracies that you have a right to protest. But what's happened to Mr. Kulkarni is, I think, beyond that legitimate right.
My colleague Amruta also joins us. In fact, she was there at that press conference. Amruta, despite this audacious attack that was made on Mr. Kulkarni, he remains undeterred and, you know, steadfast in his aim to carry on with the evening program for the launch of Mr. Kasuri's book. Can you just take us through, you know, what all now has been put in place and how really will the state government equip itself to ensure that this launch is smooth sailing and is not disrupted by any other incidents like the ones we saw earlier on in the morning?
Avantika, it seems that Sudheendra Kulkarni is quite confident that the book launch program will continue and they are not ready to cancel it in any cost. That is the reason why Sudheendra Kulkarni yesterday late night went to Matoshri to meet Uddhav Thackeray. He explained him why he wants to do this program, and he also said that if Shiv Sena wants to oppose, they have all their right to oppose the program, but do not ask us to stop the program. We will continue with the program. That was the request he made with Uddhav Thackeray. But after that, Uddhav Thackeray clearly said that Shiv Sena's stand is quite clear. We will be opposing the program. When I spoke to some of the Shiv Sena leaders and some of the members who day before yesterday went to Nehru Center to give the letter to the president there by saying that Shiv Sena is opposing this and we do not want this program to happen here in Mumbai and we do not want any Pakistani citizen to come here for the book launch. That time also the workers of Shiv Sena clearly said that it is a do or die situation for us and we will come on the streets if even if you know police give security this entire area, we will come on streets and we will protest against this. That was the reaction from Shiv Sena we got day before yesterday. Yesterday also we saw that there were many series of events taking place. The main important thing that happened yesterday night almost 9 p.m. that was we found the one burned car outside Nehru Center. Though police is not accepting this, that who had done it, police is saying that
right,
was just a case of some other reason is behind that. They are not taking Shiv Sena's name, but definitely it is a big task for Mumbai police because Shiv Sena is very aggressive in this. Even the Mumbai police knows the methods of Shiv Sena which it uses.
And speaking of that aggression, Amrita, I'll just ask you to hold on there. Speaking of that aggression and threat, you know, the Shiv Sena continues to remain unrepentant about the incident that took place earlier on in the morning when Shiv Sena activists attacked Mr. Kulkarni and smeared his face with black paint. In fact, the Shiv Sena has threatened the state government that they will continue to, you know, make such attacks in case the book launch does continue, you know, to go ahead as per schedule, which is going to happen in the evening, despite, you know, assurances made by the Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis, who has assured foolproof security to the former diplomat. Let's listen into what really the Shiv Sena spokesperson, Mr. Sanjay Raut, had to tell my colleague Kamlesh a short while back, where he has justified the attack made against Sudheendra Kulkarni.
Sir, kya bhumika hai? Muh pe kalik pochi jati hai? Hinsak tarike se virodh ho raha hai?
Ye to non-violent virodh hai. Ye kaha hinsak hai? Agar violence hota to aisa nahi hota. Ye to bahut hi mild reaction hai. Aur hame ye log keh rahe the ki aapko virodh karne ka pura adhikar hai. To Shivasena ko ne virodh kiya hai. This is non-violent protest. देखिए पाकिस्तान जो कर रहा है ना वो violence है.
लेकिन ये तरीका होता है बरोबर.
यही तरीका है. आगे बोलिए. तरीका मैं कहा कि this is mild reaction. लोगों के मन में जो संतप्त भावना है, तीव्रता है उनकी, जो कठोरता है पाकिस्तान के खिलाफ, वो देखे हुए हम लोग मानते हैं कि ये तो एकदम सीधा साधा तरीका है. ये तो जैसे हमारे में कहते हैं ना, ये तो नॉन वायलेंस है. सनतशीर जो शब्द है हम यूज करते हैं खास करके, यही है. और क्या कर सकते हैं आप?
सर आखिरी सवाल, क्या शाम को कसूरी साहब का कार्यक्रम मुंबई में हो पाएगा या नहीं? शिवसेना होने देगी?
देखिए उसके बारे में अभी टिप्पणी नहीं करूँगा, लेकिन हमारी लड़ाई जो है ना वो पाकिस्तान के खिलाफ है. हमारे भी जो सेना है ना बहुत ऊंचा और तगड़ा है. हम मरने को मिटने को तैयार है. और शिवसेना प्रमुख जी हमें जो जो सीख दी है, जो विचार दिया है, और उद्धव ठाकरे साहब भी आज जो हमें नेतृत्व दे है देने के जो मार्ग में है ना, वो इस प्रकार का है कि हम लड़ेंगे. जो हमारी ताकत है उतनी हम लड़ेंगे, चाहे हमारे साथ कोई आए ना आए, हम लड़ेंगे. हम स्वतंत्र वीर सावरकर जी हो, भगत सिंह हो, जितने उनकी ताकत थी वो लड़ते रहे. ये छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज का महाराष्ट्र राज्य है. शिवाजी महाराज ने भी अपने बलबूते पे मुगलों से लड़ाई की और अपना एक हिंदवी स्वराज्य खुद का बनाया और अपना काम किया. शिवसेना उसी राह पे चलेगी.
ओके, देयर यू हैव इट. शिवसेना क्लियरली डिफेंडिंग द प्रोटेस्ट अगेंस्ट सुधींद्र कुलकर्णी एंड कसूरी बुक लॉन्च इन मुंबई. एंड दो दे से दैट देयर फाइट फॉर दिस कॉज विल कंटिन्यू. विद कैमरा पर्सन मंगेश सावंत, कमलेश सुतार इन मुंबई फॉर इंडिया टुडे.
Okay, let's go straight now to Amrita, my colleague, who was there at the press conference which had Mr. Khurshid Mahmood Kasuri condemning the attack made against Mr. Sudheendra Kulkarni. In a press conference, they even addressed a lot of questions put forth by the journalists who were present there. So, you know, Amrita, now that we know that the organizer has said that they're not going to be cowed down by this incident and will go ahead with this book launch, can you just tell us what the book launch, you know, will be all about and who all will be attending the book launch? Will it be just Mr. Kasuri and Mr. Kulkarni, or other eminent personalities will also be attending this book launch in the evening?
See, the book launch is scheduled at 5:30 p.m. this evening at Nehru Center in Worli. And who will be the other guests, that is still not clear, because there was a dilemma whether the program will take place or not, because both the parties, whether the organizers or the opposing party Shiv Sena, both are showing equal aggression against each other. The organizers are saying that we will not stop our program, we will continue with our program with the scheduled date and time, and Shiv Sena is saying that we will not allow this to happen. So there was basically a confusion whether the program will take place or not, but now it is quite clear.
Right,
Sudheendra Kulkarni in the press conference said that we will continue with the program. So it seems that, you know, Shiv Sena, we can see many protests all over the city by Shiv Sena, whether outside Nehru Center or outside Sudheendra Kulkarni's house. So that is what we are expecting, but we have to wait and watch.
Right, Amrita. So we'll have to just see as to what really happens in the evening once the book launch does go ahead as planned earlier on by Mr. Sudheendra Kulkarni, who has organized the launch of Mr. Kasuri's book. Amrita, thanks so much for getting us the updates.